Hello everyone. Hi, this is Mahalakshmi Krishnan and welcome Raj. Welcome to Share Trek HIV again, another episode. So Raj, it's been a very happening week wherein we discussed so many things.
Yes.
First, it was A5374 and then we had TAC to talk about. And then we had this wonderful Zoom session with Jeff Galvin. And so many questions from our viewers too. So a very exciting week, I would say. So today we are going to discuss about something which is called as NEF, which is negative factor. NEF is the short form. And from what I read, it is some kind of a protein. Now, Raj, you would kind of elaborate and let us
Yes.
know about what it is exactly.
Yeah, so the question basically is, what is NEF and where does it come from? The way I understand it, I spent a couple of days reading up on this. So NEF is short for negative factor, and it's a protein that plays a crucial role in the life cycle of HIV. And it is one of the several proteins encoded by the HIV genome and is essential for the virus's ability to cause disease. So the way we should understand the genome is that the genome consists of genes. And each of those genes are actually a recipe for a protein. So typically what would happen is the cell will make a copy of the gene and throw it out, which is called as a mRNA. And then the elements in the cell will process it. And that's the recipe for a protein. The elements like tRNA and all will process it and create the protein. And protein, I think, is the currency for the body. Different proteins have different function. So this particular function, NEF, is essential for the virus's ability to cause disease. NEF has got multiple beneficial effects for the HIV virus, not for us. It performs multiple functions that help HIV to propagate. So that's the way I would position NEF.
Okay, now that we know what NEF is, what does it do? Is
okay.
what we are more interested in.
I thought you'll ask that question. Yeah. It's instrumental in the virus's ability to cause disease by helping HIV to evade the human immune system. And it also helps it to enhance its replication and deplete key immune cells. So key immune cells are CD4 T cells. So here is how I would describe the three key actions of NEF that benefit HIV. The first action is immune evasion or CD4 downregulation. So HIV lives inside the CD4 T cell and it replicates from the genome inside the CD4 T cell. So CD4 receptors on the CD4 T cell are essential for HIV to enter T cells. So by reducing the receptors on the surface of infected CD4 T cell, NEF prevents new HIV particles from infecting these already infected cells. So if you understand how HIV infects the CD4 T cells, you will know that it uses the CD4 receptor to fuse with the GP120 and then injects the RNA, which then multiplies itself and becomes a DNA and incorporates it into the host genome. But there is no specific place where the HIV will incorporate itself in the host genome. Sometimes if it incorporates in the wrong place, the person can end up getting cancer. Sometimes what could happen is if more than one copy of HIV gets into the cell, then it could embed itself into another part of the genome. So a single DNA in the cell can have multiple locations where HIV is embedded into it. So all those things can be prevented by downregulating CD4, and that's what NEF does. That's the first action. NEF triggers the internalization and degradation of CD4 receptors, thereby lowering their surface expression. Next comes its ability to engineer MHC1 downregulation. MHC1 molecules display viral fragments on the cell surface, signaling to the immune system that the cell is infected. This is crucial for cytotoxic T cells to recognize and kill the infected cells. So it's like in the old days, we had these stories about bandits coming and invading a village, and they know exactly which houses to go into because their scouts would have come the previous day and then marked those houses. And then when the bandits come, they know exactly which house to go into. MHC1 is similar to that. Any cell that has got MHC1 with a particular antigen, it's a signal for cytotoxic lymphocytes or CTLs to recognize and kill those cells. And those cells are typically infected cells. And what Nef does is it reduces the levels of MHC-1 on the surface of infected cells, thereby helping them evade detection by CTLs. It does this by redirecting MHC-1 molecules from the cell surface into the intercellular compartments where it is digested and deregulated. So that's the second action. So the second action is enhancing viral replication. Nef modifies the host cell signaling pathways and cytoskeletal structure to enhance viral replication. It interacts with various cellular proteins inside the cell to boost the production of new virus particles. And the third action is introducing apoptosis in the uninfected bystander cell. Apoptosis means the process by which a cell self-destructs because it thinks that it is invaded or it is infected. So what happens is that an infected HIV-infected CD4 T cell under the influence of Nef can trigger a series of reaction in an adjacent CD4 T cell and cause it to kill itself. So the first modality is the FAS/FASL pathway. By killing nearby uninfected CD4 T cells, Nef helps in depleting the immune system's key players. So what a Nef does is Nef increases the expression of FAS ligand, which is called FASL, on the surface of infected cell. So this surface protein then binds to FAS receptors in the neighboring uninfected CD4 T cell. And when the binding happens, the uninfected T cell triggers a cascade that leads to apoptosis or programmed cell death. And the second modality is the release of soluble factors and vesicles. This action helps extend the damage beyond directly infected cells, and Nef is packaged into extracellular vesicles such as exomes and released by infected cells. So these are all complicated mechanisms, but suffice to say that all these things enables Nef to react in multiple ways in order to suppress the human immune system and give advantage to the HIV. The impact of HIV pathogenesis consists of following: immune system breakdown, which is the continuous depletion of CD4 T cells, which are crucial for orchestrating the immune response. And this leads to a weakened immune system and progression towards AIDS. This makes the body more susceptible to opportunistic infection and cancers characteristic of AIDS. And the second thing it does is the virus persistence. It helps the virus to persist by evading immune detection in the cells that it resides in and helps in its replication. And Nef ensures the persistence and spread of HIV within the host. And that's how it goes about doing all the damage that it does. So it's not just one action. It is three different actions which help HIV get an upper hand and an advantage to persist.
Good. So three different actions for Nef, right?
Yes.
So thank you, Raj, for that. Okay, now that we understood Nef, so how does it open avenues for treatment, for developing treatments in this area?
Right. So I've been studying up on that because I got excited with the way NEF works. So if NEF is a protein, if you consider it an antigen, protein and antigen, we can possibly interchangeably use the term, then we should have an antibody which can neutralize Nef. So that was my first thought. So my research on Google led me to a page where I discovered about Mitchell Mumby, who is a PhD candidate from Schulich School of Medicine and Dentistry, and he is working on Nef. And Mumby will present his work in isolating various Nef sequences to a multidisciplinary session at the Canadian Conference of HIV and AIDS Research to be held in at Royal Bank Canada Place on RBC Place on April 25 to 28. So that's what I read out there. Now, April 25 to 28 has just passed. So I'm looking forward to see his papers being published, what exactly he spoke out there. So that can give us some kind of an indication. And the other thing I'm thinking about is that Nef causes kind of surface proteins to appear on CD4 T cells, which when they anchor into healthy CD4 T cells, the FAS/FASL mechanism is what I'm referring to. If there could be an antibody that can latch on to FASL or FAS, then it can prevent the binding of CD4 uninfected cell with CD4 infected cells. And as a result of which, what would happen is that CD4 cell depletion, healthy CD4 cell depletion can be arrested, and the NEF action on that could be arrested. So that's another avenue in which I think scientists may be working on. So those are the areas that I think, in my mind, as a non-scientist, attacks can be done to help HIV patients to get a better handle on HIV within their bodies.
So is there any work going on with regard to the research into NEF?
The work that is being done by Mumbi is one thing that I can point to. And I don't see any other work so far in my looking at, you know, this particular topic, but I might find something in the future which I can talk about. And I suspect there'll be some ART in place which works on NEF. I remember reading that in the past, but I don't have it handy right now. But overall, I would say that NEF provides an exciting opportunity to arrest HIV. And so far, all if you exclude Excision Bio and American Gene Technologies, these two companies, all the other initiatives that have been attempted and all the ART that we have in the market, antiretroviral therapies we have in the market, have been targeting the various life stages of HIV. So there are reverse transcriptase, which try to prevent transcription of HIV RNA into DNA. And there are inhibitors which try to prevent HIV from creating virions. There are other aspects that have been used in creating ART. So I'm pretty sure there must be some ART which targets NEF, but I really don't know at this point of time if there is more work going on it other than Mumbi's work on NEFs.
So we wait for the 25th to 28th when the results of the research would be out. And it's absolutely happening in Canada. So
yeah, absolutely. So April 25th to 28th is already passed. So we are already in the middle of May. But what happens typically is that all these research papers go behind a paywall in research publications, where until you have an institutional membership or something, you will not be able to access those documents. It's meant only for scientists and research scientists. So I'm thinking that it will take a little time before someone shares that kind of information with us. So I would look forward to that. And also, just to address our broader audience, in terms of expectation management, we are ordinary people who are not doctors or scientists. Then I had I had one of the subscribers the other day making a comment saying that, you know, if you're not doctors or scientists, then why are you publishing? So the choice in front of me and in front of that subscriber is twofold, the way I see it. One is for me to just wind down this channel and say, okay, we are not doctors, we are not scientists, why do we want to make any videos? Just shut it down and just go away, right? The other is for that subscriber to manage their expectations on what they are going to get. My question is there any research scientist or doctor who is willing to answer all your questions the way you ask me here and I'm answering? If the answer is fine, follow that.
I believe, Raj, that you're giving them a very safe space to talk about their concerns. And I feel that you are a kind of a bridge between them and the doctors. I mean, whatever research is coming out, you're giving them the actual idea about it. And nothing is, there is no wrong information going out, which is very important.
That's the most important thing. I try to avoid wrong information. There is a lot of filters that I have put in our channel, because there are a lot of people out there trying to fleece HIV patients with some kind of miracle cure and all. So I have the name of somewhere around 30 odd doctors from Africa who claim to have cure. And then I have blocked so many people who claim to have got cured by those things. And so I have done those things to safeguard our audience. I am also reading only from reputed journals and reputed sources like NIH in order to bring the information out here. I do not sell anything that you need to buy in terms of therapies or in terms of any supplements or anything. So I don't do any of those things. So I don't have any interest in that. And the other thing for that particular individual would be that they need not see the channel. Like if you think that we are not credible, then don't watch the channel. But there are thousands of people. There is around, at last count, we have around 11,000 odd subscribers. We got Patreons and we got members who all find value in the channel. So I would like to continue doing stuff for those people. And now Maha,
and I have read
Yes,
I have read a few comments whereby a few of them are actually so, you know, they're so positive when they talk. They say that you give us hope.
Yeah, and which that is the idea.
And you really feel like doing, I mean, working for them or doing something for them.
That's what makes me, yeah, that's what makes me work on this, because otherwise my interest is in actually investment and that's where my heart is. But I'm able to take some time out from my life and put it out here, knowing that it is something altruistic and that would make me feel good. That is my reward. But we have to manage expectations. So that's what I would say. You come here for genuine information. You come here for reliable information. And I'll give it to you in a realistic manner. I won't give you false hope. But at the same time, I believe that whether you have diabetes, whether you have cancer, whether you got HIV, all of them are progressively taking a piece of your life until a cure comes.
They're debilitating diseases.
They are all diseases. All of them. Yeah, and it's a serious thing. I appreciate a serious situation in which you are. But at the same time, what I am saying is that our space out here has to be positive. Come here to give positive vibes. If you feel negative, go to a counselor, get it out with the counselor, or write in a sheet of paper, do something, but don't bring negativity into the channel. Because when you're negative, it's in your headspace. But when you put it in the comments here, it's a chain reaction. It's going to 11,000 people. Some of them might already be in the verge of being absolutely despondent, and you're just pushing them over the edge. So, and also you're bringing down the positive people. So for heaven's sake, don't put negative comments here. Put positive comments. And if you don't have anything positive to say, don't comment. Just watch or don't watch, do whatever.
Well said. Okay, on that note, Raj, that's all from us today, yes. I think. Thank you so much, and God bless. Have a wonderful day ahead.
See you later, guys. Thanks, Maha. Bye.
Thank you.